إن الحمد لله الذي نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونتوب إليه من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. الحمد لله موجد الوجود الموجود قبل كل وجود، والصلاة والسلام على خير الوجود وعلى آله وأصحابه إلى يوم القيامة. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الكلام كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى، وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. طبتم وطاب سعيكم وممشاكم، وتبوأتم جميعا من الجنة منزلا. دع عنك ما قد فات في زمن الشبا، واذكر ذنوبك وابكى عليها يا مذنب، لا ينساك الملكان حين نسيتهما، بل أفضتاه وأنت لاهب تلعب. أروح منك وديعة وديتها، فترد بالرقم منك وتسلو، وغرور دنياك التي تسعى لها دار حقيقتها متاع يذهب. الليل فاعلم والنهار كلاهما أنفاسنا فيهما تعد وتحسب. كيف حالنا مع الله؟ كيف أمورنا معه سبحانه وتعالى؟ يقول سبحانه وتعالى في محكم تنزيله: ومن أعرض عن ذكري فإن له معيشة ضنكا ونحشره يوم القيامة أعمى. قال رب لم حشرتني أعمى؟ قال رب لم حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا. قال كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى. We praise Allah. We praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whom is the source of all existence. Allah is the source of all existence. Al-mawjood qabla kulli wujood. In fact, Allah has existed before all existence. We also extend salutation to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who is the best of all existence. Today's khutbah, inshallah, like I have always said, wa wallah, seeing yourself to be a Muslim, it is the best thing that will ever happen to you. Therefore, I want to speak on something again that is very personal. It's about me first before you, all of you, my dear sisters and brothers in Islam. That is, what is your relationship with Allah?
Now, we are sitting here, each and every one of us should be asking ourselves.
Generally, you have two categories of relationships. You have the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have self-relationship, that's your relationship with yourself. And the third category of relationship, and of course each of these categories, each one you have other categories of relationship. But But these are the three ones. These are the three. First, what is the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The second, what is the relationship with yourself? Because Allah says, Bali insanu ala nafsihi khaseera. Each and every one of us knows ourselves. We know ourselves than any other person. The third category is your relationship with other people. Now, these three relationships, when one is not taken care of properly, the rest of the other relationships will be destroyed. That is your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So that is an open question to me and to all of you. What is our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because Allah said in Surah وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي For whosoever that turns his back and dhikri on my servants, I mean, he said in 7 minutes, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةَ الدَّرْكَ He or she will have a confused life. Whosoever turns his back on my service, that is in obeying me, he or she will have a confused life. So now, we have realized that most of what we do, we always have problems. And the reason is that the first thing that we're supposed to do, we have forgotten it. That is putting Allah first. You know, Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah, in this one that I love so much, and each time I'm given the chance to speak, I like to talk about it. He said, "Wa umuru dunyaka allati tas'a laha." This dunya that we are moving, all of us running after. He said, "Darun, it is a place. Haqiqatuha mata'un yadhhab. It will be vanished." Sometimes even in our homes, in our marriages, nowadays, the husbands, the wives, they no longer work together. We should be asking ourselves, why is it my wife is giving me tough time? Why is it my husband no longer understands me? We should be asking ourselves this question, because if our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is properly handled, well, wallahi, Allah will soften your wife for you. Allah will soften your husband for you. But it's because we have to put Allah first. Unfortunately, we have placed him last. Allah says, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً دَنْكَ And this is the Quran. Nobody can reject that. Whosoever turns their back in worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِنَّ لَهُ In fact, Allah did not just say, he will have a confused life. He said, indeed, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً دَنْكَ Indeed, he will have, or she will have a confused life. And this is why today most of us will think that when you have the dunya, then everything will fall in place. Other than, wallahi, anyone who dunya takes away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dunya will never be the source of bringing him back. I repeat that. Whosoever dunya takes away from Allah, dunya takes him or her away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, dunya will never be the source of bringing him or her to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This very clear is a simple formula. Wallahi, whatsoever we are doing, if we don't put Allah first, you will have, you know, a static joining. That is, you will be moving with high speed. Before you look, you come back to square one where you begin from. Because you never put what's supposed to be put first. May Allah protect me and myself. Or else, you will now see that dunya has taken us to the extent nothing in our life will take of Allah first. Nothing. If your child gets sick, the first thing that comes on your mind, no dua for the child. The first thing that comes on your mind is your insurance. The doctor. I had to go and see the doctor. You forget about Allah. Who was Shafi? It is Allah who kills. Treatment is necessary. We are not talking about that to take treatment is not real. But when you have any challenge, the first thing that comes on your mind should be Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In your marriage. Why is your marriage struggling? Is it because of dunya? Is it because the man is not working? Or is it because you, the woman, you are making more money? Now, other than, it's possible the struggle in your home is because of you, the woman. It's because of you, the husband. You should be asking yourself. In fact, before inviting anybody into your home, get to Allah first. Call your wife. See her? I think we no longer understand each other. Can we go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because that's the meeting. For whosoever you keep going to, that person is human being. That person carries a heart. And that heart is controlled by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If your relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not properly taken care of, I am sorry. Allah says we have a confused life. May Allah protect me ourselves.
Amen.
And the examples are many. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, according to Ibn Abbas, ستعرف على الله في شدة يعرفك في الرخاء تعرف على الله في الرخاء يعرفك في شدة. Know Allah when everything is okay. Think of Allah. When things are difficult with you, think of Allah. When things are hard for you, think of Allah. But in this hadith, he said when everything is okay with you, that's the time you focus on Allah. I was telling my friend who is now with us in his mosque, like, brother, look, when everything is fine with me, I am worried. Because the opposite of that is also correct. It's also possible. That is, when everything is going all your way, that's the time you have to worry when everything shall turn around. Unfortunately, when everything is going on our way the way we want to, we claim that Allah loves us. Abadan. But Allah wants to try you. Allah says, "When I blow up the shadow of Zaydi, fitna. Until we try you, we test you from goodness, from success, and that of difficulty." So both, when everything is going with you, you should also know that Allah is testing you. And when everything is not going on your way, know also that Allah is testing you. So the best solution is to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say, "Kun ma'allahi yakun ma'ak." And this is one of the verses in the Quran that is repeated in many areas. "Inna Allah ma'al mu'minin." "Inna Allah ma'as sabirin." "Inna Allah ma'al muhsinin." The ma'iyya, for Allah to be with you. Because when Allah is with you, nothing goes against you. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is in favor, nobody will ever have it. But our greatest problem today is we have forgotten the relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we have many other relationships. And once you do that, you will have a challenge. May Allah protect me. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you know, the night he was attacked by the Quraysh, you know, it was a very tough night for him, alayhi sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But see what he did. He said to himself, "Wallahi, if Allah, it is the one that sent me on this mission, he will never forsake me." And what happened? He woke up and walked in the presence of Quraysh. They surrounded the house. He walked without seeing him. Alayhi salatu wa salam. Man yabni ma Allah. Anyone that Allah is with you, who will go against you? When he also escaped, he left and he was waiting for Abu Bakr Siddiq, radiallahu anhu. When the two of them were in a cave, the people realized that they have already, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has already left the place, his house. They pursued him. And unfortunately, they went to the cave. And they were in a cave. Abu Bakr Siddiq and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were in a cave. Abu Bakr Siddiq told him, he said, "Wallahi, law nadhara ahadun ila qadamayhi." If they are now in a cave, the Prophet and Abu Bakr Siddiq, they are in a cave. And those Quraysh, they are there now to get rid of him. And Abu Bakr said in a very low tone, "Say, Wallah, if any of them would just look down to their feet, they will see us." And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam talked, looked at Abu Bakr Siddiq and said to him, "Yeah, Abu Bakr, what do you think? That two persons somewhere and the third person is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." And this is what we want to talk about. He said, "Abu Bakr, what do you think of two persons that the third person is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" That is, they will never be able to see us. And that's what we're supposed to be doing. Oh Allah, when the dunya is coming upon you, you are going through a lot. What you need to do is to focus on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because, like I said, everything around us will be in view of us or against us. And you want your Allah, your wife, your children, your husband, property, all these things are just for the sake of dunya. If any of us dies right now, we realize that the wife that you support soon at will be afraid to enter where you are. And the opposite too. And the wife that you love, at times really men we are a little bit brave. When you start to call the person a dead body, you don't know what to do. In fact, you are doing everything and every arrangement to go and marry you. So if somebody you are so much important to people, they will have buried you. So if you are with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah, everything is before you. But when you leave Allah behind, you are going to go back. And the worst of it, most of us will not be fortunate enough to return to Allah because it will be too late. Allah says, "Hatta idha jaa ahadam al-maut, qala rabbi irji'un." Until then, when one of them, death comes to one of them, they say, "Please, Allah, prolong me." No, it's too late. You're supposed to have been with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you'll be able to understand your life. When you left Allah behind, and the dunya succeed. Because there are two groups you have. Hizbullah or Hizbul Shaitan. Two groups. A group of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to become a proper servant, to be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once you are not on that path, you will get to another group, that's Shaitan, the dunya. Of Allah. So may Allah protect me and myself.
Amen.
We should be asking ourselves, what is our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And the difficulties that we are having, whether it is domestic, it is in your workplace, it's with your wife, your children, ask yourself. Allah has absolute control over any condition, anyone. He can change anything, anytime he wants to. But unfortunately, we have forgotten. Wallah. Like the homes. Wallah, most homes, they have fire. Only because the husband has forgotten about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the way. And once this is the case, there is no solution. The best solution is to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because when you go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows what is wrong. Allah says, "Asa an takrahu shay'an wa huwa khayrun lakum." There are things that we don't like. Perhaps you are married to a woman you don't love. You are married to a man you don't love. But who knows? That man is the one that will be the source of your gender. You want to take everything to yourself. Everything is about yourself. And unfortunately, yourself is supposed to be for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. Allah says, "Nasullah fanasiyam." When you forget Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah also says, He will forget you. May Allah protect us.
Amen.
الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. إن لله عبادا فطنا طلقوا الدنيا وخافوا الفتنا فلما نظروا فيها أنها ليس للحي وطنا جعلوها لجة جعلوها لجة وجعلوا فيها صالح الأعمال فيها سفنا. الدنيا is a farm. One of the mistakes, because once you are with Allah, Allah will now give you the wisdom of understanding everything. Because He has created everything. So once you claim that you know it all, or you will live the way you want to, you live it. Dunya is a farm. Imam Shafi said, "Allah has created us among the servants. Allah has created us from people that He has given them intelligence. They have divorced the dunya." Divorce in the sense that they just make use of the dunya. They make use of the dunya. What benefits them in this dunya and the year after is what they go after. Whatsoever that will take them far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they avoid it. and don't hear anyone you make this place to be a home. Oh Allah, nothing becomes your portion except temptation, stress, problems, and you name them. Because this place is temporary. Any condition is in this place is not permanent. You may be poor yesterday, today you are rich. You have money. You may be sick yesterday, today you are well. Today you may be rich, but Allah, tomorrow you may be poor. In fact, all of us, we are poor already. Because Allah said in the Quran, Ya ayyuha an-nas antum al-fuqara. Human beings, we are poor. I don't care about you. Because when you end your life, you die.
Will you carry your money?
No, I don't know. So let's be with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let's observe our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will guide us, he will protect us. But once we put Adam last, we will now get into a perpetual confusion. May Allah protect me himself.
Amen.
Our children today. Somebody was telling me that their daughter no longer listen to them. They do what they want to do. Yes, the best solution you have to do is to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua. Of course, that is after a long journey, of course. Because a marriage is like a farm. You want to make a farm. You have to observe the woman before you marry. You have to observe a lot of things. So when the time comes, it does have a result. And Allah does not tell lies. So وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتُمْ ذُرِّيَّتُهُمْ بِإِيمَانٍ أَلْحَقْنَا بِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَمَا أَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. If you in a room, and this is what we are saying, Allah says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those that believe. Wallahi, if you want for your child to listen to you, you want for your mom to be peaceful, go back to Allah. Tell your wife, Wallahi, it is time that we forget about all this fire and go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because it's the only solution. Our parents, in fact, at times to know that when you avoid Allah, your problems only increase and never decrease. Because in certain conditions, your wife, the hope will be if your wife or your husband is no longer listening to you, to call the family. At times, the family become the greater problem to your marriage. But Allah is never the case. Allah is never the case of Allah. So please, and I'm saying this because almost everybody is faced with a problem. And the only way you will have a relief is to go back to Allah. Not the dunya. The dunya is an open ocean. Oh Allah, you'll never see the end. The Prophet ﷺ says, a dunya hold what we hold. The dunya we are in. Here. Well, anyway, Prophet ﷺ describes it to be a fruit that never gets red. I don't care what you do here. Next year, 2024, 2025, 2026, things that you will see, you will not see them in 2023. So the dunya is just like that. You can't be making use of it. You look for your answer and you go. But once you forget about Allah, Allah says, Nasullaha fanasiyahu. You forget Allah, then Allah forgets them. And if just imagine that Allah forgets you. May Allah take us to him, may Allah do that for us.
Amen.
Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina
adhaban nar. Amen.
Rabbana la tuzigh qulubana ba'da idh hadaytana wa hab lana min ladunka rahmah innaka antal wahhab. Allahumma la tad' lana fi maqamina hadha dhanban illa ghafarta.
Amen.
Wa la maridan illa shafaita. Wa la dhalan illa hadayta. Wa la dhalan illa hadayta. Wa la dhalan illa hadayta. Wa la hajata min hawaihi wal akhirati illa qadayta.
Amen.
Wa yassartaha bi rahmatika ya
سبحانه
الله اكبر الله اكبر.
الله أكبر.
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت ذكرى سيذكر من يخشى ويتجنبها الأشقى الذي يصلى النار الكبرى ثم لا يموت فيها ولا يحيا قد أفلح من تزكى وذكر اسم ربه فصلى بل تؤثرون الحياة الدنيا والآخرة خير وأبقى إن هذا لفي الصحف الأولى صحف إبراهيم وموسى الله أكبر
سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر
الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. هل أتاك حديث الغاشية وجوه يومئذ خاشعة عاملة ناصبة تصلى نارا حامية تسقى من عين آنية ليس لهم طعام إلا من ضريع لا يسمن ولا يغني من جوع وجوه يومئذ ناعمة لسعيها راضية في جنة عالية لا تسمع فيها لاغية فيها عين جارية فيها سرر مرفوعة وأكواب موضوعة والنمارق مصفوفة وزرابي مبثوثة أفلا ينظرون إلى الإبل كيف خلقت وإلى السماء كيف رفعت وإلى الجبال كيف نصبت وإلى الأرض كيف سطحت فذكر إنما أنت مذكر لست عليهم بمسيطر إلا من تولى وكفر فيعذبه الله العذاب الأكبر إن إلينا إيابهم ثم إن علينا حسابهم. الله أكبر. سمع الله لمن حمده. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. الله أكبر. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
في سبيل الله. في سبيل الله. في سبيل الله. We thank our Imam, Sheikh Mohammed Tiaou, for this powerful khutbah today, this reminder. May Allah increase His knowledge for us. You know, anytime Allah.